ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయ జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ది ఆల్ మైటీ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఆల్ ద క్రీచర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద యూనివర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 52 ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ యదా తే మోహకలిలం బుద్ధిర్వ్యతితరిష్యతి తదా గంతాసి నిర్వేదం శ్రోతవ్యస్య శ్రుతస్య చ. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ హూ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ బుద్ధియోగ వెరీ వెల్ అప్ టు లాస్ట్ వర్డ్స్, బట్ హీ సేస్ బట్ అర్జున you have one more obstruction for this buddhi yoga. You need a buddhi which is not deluded. What is this delusion? Our buddhi is occupied by deluded karma phalas. Once your buddhi is deluded, you cannot select proper karma without karma phala. You go and get attached with the karma phala. Now what is this delusion? In Sanskrit we call it moham, and also known as mohaha. This moha means what? Let me give an example. There was two friends who were friends from the childhood. They studied together from 5th standard to the highest studies. They completed the college. One person, he could go abroad to establish his own company in abroad. Another one, he is working in his own city. That's what karma phala, you know. Though they were together, studied together and everything, this person is more talented than that person in studies, but he could succeed there and he could establish very good company. Then what happened? This Ram, who is in his own native place, in the own city, he was struggling for money. And this Naresh who is in US, he said, if you are finding very difficult, you can use my house for your living purpose. This Ram is married one, therefore he got that home. He used to send the rent. Now, the rent, though it is minimum rent to a friend, he doesn't want to live as a free person. The years went after 5 years. Okay, that Naresh, one day he called. He said, I would like to give a happiest message to you, Ram. Ram said, yes, yes, of course, tell me. Naresh said, I am coming back to our own place. I am done here in US. Then Ram was so happy, but at the same time he became very sad. Then he kept the phone. He came to a sad mood and returned home. He was talking to his wife, the Naresh is going to come back. This house, you know, this house belongs to him. Therefore, we should see some other house for living purpose. He was worrying much. Then the next day again he called. At that time Ram said, okay Naresh, when are you coming back? I have to vacate the house. I need sometimes at least 1 month to find some other house nearby. I have to, because my office is nearby, I need to get, I will let you know. Then Naresh said, oh dear, I don't need that house. You take the house that belongs to you. Okay, I have a new house which I bought near the beach. Okay, day after tomorrow I am coming. I will meet there, my dear. Bye bye. He put the phone. Now this Ram has become very joyful. From the office, when he reached the home, he looked at that apartment. Now his mind is full of, this is my house. When he entered home, that time his son was doing some drawing something on the wall. He shouted, "Idiot, don't you know that it should not be done, karke?" Now it has become his own house. He has become more conscious. That boy, he used to write a lot. Whole walls were filled with that drawings. At that time he was not shouting at him. Now he started shouting, "Moham, my house." That my house makes Buddhi deluded. Okay. And in my life also there was an incident. It's very subtle, you know. This moha is very subtle and powerful. It will delude like anything. One Swami Chinmayananda, who was great Swamiji, he had a discourses, series of discourses for a week. I was invited, my friends, I refused to go there. I was busy with some work. I was too young at that time. Then he said that Swamiji, you know, he gives discourses in English. Then I thought, okay, sannyasi giving lectures in English? Okay, he's learned one. At that time we were not, you know, completely aware about what the Shastra is. Though at that time itself I had the by heart Bhagavad Gita, but not knowing complete meaning of it. That's what, you know, samskara. When you were born in a house, the house which gives priority to Shastra, that is bone. So I had a good opportunity. I could learn Bhagavad Gita. I could chant it well from the childhood. Then first day I was not able to go. Second day I was not able to go. Third day, somehow my friends made, okay, chalo, you have to come. When I went there, my God, the personality, it was like, he was like a roaring lion. The delivery, what kind of delivery of, when Krishna speaks, Krishna alone speaks. When Arjuna speaks, Arjuna alone is seen in him. My God, wonderful. Then I was just lost in his teaching. Just I was observing his teaching, my friend pinched me and said, "You look at his hand." I looked at his hand. "What is there? Did you see the watch?" "Yes." "That watch. Do you know what the brand is?" I said, "What the brand?" "Because for me all the watch are the same. Because they are useful to keep yourself fit for the time. Though times are myths, they are mithya, but in order to do vyavahara, we should follow certain time." Then I said, "What is there in watch? Watch is a watch." He said, "No, it's not a mere watch. It's a Rolex watch." And I said, "Rolex means what?" "Oh my God, don't you know that only these business people, highly, high level people, tycoon people, they only wear it." Then I amazed, "Oh my God, that Swamiji, how can he wear a Rolex watch?" Then all attention was turned to watch. You know, whatever that waves and movement of that watch, I was lost myself in the watch. Then the next day, we were sitting on the left. Means we were sitting the opposite side, left side. We wanted to take the seat. When I entered that auditorium, just I was taking a right side. Immediately my friend asked, "Why we had our seat yesterday this side? Why do you want to go there?" Then I said, "Just we will sit here." He said, "For what? To see watch clearly?" Then it was hammering like on my head. My God, this Buddhi, how it works. that Swamiji, he doesn't have attachment, somebody might have given to him, because sannyasi means a Raja Rishi, and this simple living means not be endowed with Daridra. Okay? Daridra is not, Daridra Buddhi is not a sannyasi. Sannyasi is a king. Sannyasi is a king and he is not endowed with attachment. It doesn't mean that if somebody gives, he should deny it. It depends on person to person, the definition which is given to it. That was not the matter there. That was, there was the matter of the watch. Then I took left. That's what moha is. Moha is very subtle. You have to be very, very careful. If you have a buddhi, the buddhi which have crossed the impurity of the delusion, that buddhi is endowed with vairagya. That vairagya yukta, the buddhi which is endowed with vairagya alone, suitable for buddhi yoga. Dhananjaya, hey Arjuna, you have to be clear in this matter. And the buddhi which doesn't have moha, it cannot be deluded by the enjoyments of this world, and it cannot be deluded by the enjoyments of Surga, etc., worlds which are mentioned in our Vedas. All this Karma Kanda people, they say, if you do this puja, you will get more powerful state here, and after this life also you can get. You won't be deluded. Therefore, you need to have that much stronger buddhi. The same thing continues in the next verse also, Lord Krishna. Shruti vipratipannate yadasthasyati nishchala samadhavachala buddhihi tada yogama vapsyasi. You have to be at samadhi. You have to gain a kind of state which is known as meditation. Completely focused, ekagrata chittam, niruddha chittam. That's what Patanjali defines. But here, Acharya says, samadhau means samadhiyate chittam asminiti samadhi. Atma tasmin atmani iti etat. Just, you know, a buddhi which is endowed with inner self, not a fluctuated one. So calm and cool with every action. Your buddhi, if it is not deluded, it means what? It is established in yourself. Therefore, the buddhi which should be endowed with the samadhi alone will bring this yogam into your life. Then he says, the buddhi is amazing. How can I get? Therefore he asked the question. Now Arjuna, first time after all the teaching of second chapter is being completed, he begins. Till now Bhagavan Krishna has taught Brahma Vidya and Karma Vidya. Brahma Vidya was from 11th verse onwards, 30th verse. Karma Vidya from 31 to here 53. Now Arjuna asked the question. Let us see what he asked. Sthita prajnasya ka bhasha samadhisthasya keshavam sthita dhikram prabhasheta kimasi tavrajeta kim. Now Arjuna has the question. Let us see what he asked. Sthita prajnasya ka bhasha samadhisthasya keshavam sthita dhikram prabhasheta kimasi tavrajeta kim. Now Arjuna, he is informed one, but still he has a kind of struggling with the understanding. Because this Shastra, it teaches completely against practical life. Therefore, whenever you say there is a Bhagavad Gita class, you can find the students more than 70. it somehow these it has arrived, this attitude has been arrived to our society. I don't know how it has come. Bhagavad Gita must be studied in engage, not in the age in which you are not able to hear, you cannot see, you cannot think even. Shastrasya phalam kinchitapi nasti. You cannot get benefit by Shastra. If you want to get benefit by Shastra, you have to study at proper age. So when you have energy to think, energy to see, energy to do something, when you are energetic person, you begin spiritual life so that you could conclude your life in proper way. Now Arjuna asks, you know, Ho Bhagavan Krishna, Sthita Prajnasya Ka Bhasha. You described a person who is established his buddhi, that buddhi which is established known as Sthita Prajnam. That person is called Sthita Prajnaha. So how he will look alike? How he speaks? He says, how does he speak? Means what? So what will he speak with the world? What kind of communication that he will set? Because normal people, they have the communication because they have something to share with others. They also have filled with expectation, therefore what? They have to mingle with others, they have to get transaction done. But for this Sthita Prajnaha, you said that he is a self-established person, then for him there is no need for any transaction. Will he do transaction? If at all he does transaction, so what kind of transaction he will be? That's what he says. Sthita prajnasya ka bhasha. Bhasha means language, but here it's a communication. What kind of communication he will set with other people? Samadhisthasya keshava. The person who is established in samadhi. Sthita dhih kim prabhashayata. And what kind of buddhi that he would own? How can we understand? You said that the buddhi which is established in samadhi, how can we understand? Nobody can understand. The spiritual progress is like traveling amidst of the ocean. You cannot see how long you traveled. That is what the problem is. He says, sthithadhih kim prabhashayata, kimasita brajayata kim. What would be the lifestyle belongs to him? And the life he will take towards what? Because every day will begin. So what kind of job he will do? What kind of lifestyle he will, what he will eat, what will think, what we will talk, how he will look like? Now Arjuna wants to get evidence, because whatever the things said by Krishna, it seems to be impractical. Because still people think that it is impractical. Spiritual is an impractical thing. No, it is not like that. It is very practical. To be a samsari is impractical, I tell you. Because we are given all the data about us from outside. Some data is given. When people name for their babies, they are superimposing that. It is against nature. When they specify, you belong to my family, my community, my language, my nation, all of them are superimposed. That alone very difficult. When you talk about your real nature, it's not against, it is not impractical. That alone practical thing is. We have to realize, spiritual means it's very practical. Very practical means not living in the imaginative world. It is a very practical world. He knows what cannot be seen by the eyes. That buddhi is so subtle, it could understand what the reality behind every object in the world. And the incidents or accidents which happens in our life, the buddhi should not be victimized. so-called practical people are victimized, and therefore they are very deluded. They don't know they are deluded. That's what is known as a delusion. Mohaha. Now Krishna understood. Okay, chalo. So he wants to get evidence. He talks about quality of a jnani, quality of a jnani who is also yogi. Now from here to till end of this chapter, he will be narrating who is a wise person, so that you could get connected with the concept which whatever that he unfolded. Let us begin. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Prajahati Yada Kaman Sarvan Partha Manogatan Atman Yevatmana Tushtaha Stheta Prajna Tadochyate Sarvan He Partha Sarvan Manogatan Kaman Yada Prajahati Atmani Yeva Atmana Stheta Prajna Tushtaha. That tushtaha tadasthita prajnaha uchyate. That person can be called sthita prajnaha, who has given up all the desires which are generated in the mind, who has established in his self, himself, by himself. That person can be called wise person, sthita prajnaha. Arjuna was blinking eyes. I asked for the evidence, but the definition of a jnani, it seems to be so difficult to realize. No, it's not that much difficult. We can understand. He says, Yada manogatan sarvan kaman prajahati. Now he says, the mind is a place from where all the desires are originated. Now this person, he keeps himself as the witness to all the desires, that which arises from the pond called mind. He is not shaken by those thoughts. Mind is like a pond. Pond has got so many plants, you know. That plants, varieties of plants, like wishes, desires, the mind is the place from where all the desire keep on coming. You need not to see the object. You keep a person locked for 5 days and see him, he will get more desires. The mind keep on doing, bringing new desires. After 5 days, open him, he will run like anything. The mind alone problematic. This person, he gives up. He is not shaken by the desires. Why? Because he is Atmani Tushtaha. Atmani Tushtaha means he is satisfied in the self, with the self. Atmana Atmani Tushtaha. He doesn't need any object in the world. He even doesn't depend on the body. No other source is required to be happy for this person. That person is called sthita prajnaha. It seems to be rogue, arrogant. No, it's very relaxed, not shaken by any experience which is taking place in the mind. Mind is the pond. So many birds come and sit, and so many flowers come out of it. He is just like a water as a sakshi. It's a beautiful verse to define who is jnani. He lives in the world and he enjoys being as the subject, not being connected with object. He realizes himself as the subject, not like an object. Krishna doesn't lose, means doesn't leave Arjuna like this, because Arjuna is struggling to understand by this verse. This 55th verse is the verse which is going to be explained up to the end of this chapter. Therefore, we need not worry about it. But you can have a definition. A person who is self-satisfied, he doesn't require even his body, mind, experiences and the worldly object. No. Because he could feel that I am all pervasive. I am nothing but Paramatma. Paramatma and me are the same. That is a complete understanding about the self. Now, the person who has realized about self, he doesn't need anything from outside. That person can be called Sthita Prajnaha. And if you say hello, he will say hello. He won't say that I am established in my buddhi. No. He will live a normal life. He will appear normal. Normal means what? He need not to talk in slow motion. You need not to pretend anything. His life is so normal. The body gestures, everything. It may look confident, it may not look confident, but he lives a normal life. But inner growth is 100% have been taken place. Next words, Dukhesh Vanudvignamanaha Sukhesh Vigataspruhaha Bita Raga Bhaya Krodhaha Sthita Dhir Munir Uchyate. The next words of Sthita Prajnasya Lakshanam, the definition of a wise person who is also yogi. You cannot find the driving forces for the karma in his mind because he is away from raga, bhaya, krodaha. These three raga means desires, likes and dislikes are together said as a raga. Raga and dvesha and bhaya. Bhaya means fear. Fundamental emotion is called fear and krodaha, anger. He is free from anger, he is free from bhayam means fear, he is free from likes and dislikes. His mind is free from these three. If a mind which is free from these three, how could a desire will take place? Because the desire is the driving force for the karma. Then what kind of karma will take place in his mind? And also he says, Dukheshu anudvignamanaha sukheshu vigataspruhaha. He will be as the witness for both happiness and sadness. It means what kind of vyavahara, transaction, how he will react. If you are taking a birthday gift, when you come to know that today is his birthday, when you give birthday gift, wish you a happy birthday, how he will react. He continues, that we will see in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.